Welcome. In this course, you have already seen several ways to describe curves in the plane. For example, consider this circle. To describe the circle, I ought to give a couple of characteristics. It is the circle with radius 2 and center 4,3. And this information completely describes the curve. As you've seen before, another possibility is to describe the circle using formulas. In this example, the circle consists of all points whose distance to the center is equal to 2. The Pythagorean theorem gives us the following equation for the x and y coordinates of such a point: x minus 4 squared plus y minus 3 squared equals 4. The nice thing about this equation is that it can be used to check whether a point lies on the curve or not. If we take, for example, the point 2,2, we see that 2 minus 4 squared plus 2 minus 3 squared adds up to 5. And this is not 4, so we know that the point 2,2 does not lie on the circle. And you can check graphically that this is indeed the case. We call such a formula an implicit description of the circle. In this video, we will discuss a third approach to describe curves, namely by parametrization. To explain this concept, imagine a mouse running around on the curve. The position of the mouse changes with time, so we can regard its x and y coordinates as functions of a time parameter t. These functions are appropriately called the coordinate functions of the parametrization. In this case, we can describe these functions by the formulas on the slide. If our mouse loops the circle exactly once, we can regard the positions of this mouse as the collection of points on the circle, and therefore we can say that our formulas describes the circle as well. To make sure that the mouse only loops the circle once, we have to restrict the values of t to the interval 0,2 pi. This is called the parameter interval. Note that the mouse trail explicitly gives us all the points on our circle. Simply take a value of t in the parameter interval and plug it into the coordinate functions. This way we can find all points on the curve. We say that the parametrization is an explicit description of our circle. You may wonder which is better, to use an equation as a description of the curve or a parametrization. And the answer really depends on what you want to do. For example, we saw that an equation it makes it easy to check whether a given point lies on the curve. This is harder if you only have a parametrization. On the other hand, if you want to find points on the curve, a parametrization is easier to use than an equation. Let's have a look at some properties of parametrizations. The parametric description of our circle is given by the white mouse is not unique. It made a choice of starting point, of direction, and of pacing. This gray mouse over here might make some different choices. It stops and starts and changes pace a couple of times, but that's okay. It still describes the circle we're interested in. The corresponding coordinate functions and the parameter interval for the gray mouse are completely different from those of the white mouse, but both provide a parametrization of the curve. Actually, given a curve, there are infinitely many parametrizations that describe it. A natural question to ask is, would any mouse trail do to set up a parametrization? And the answer is no. Some things are not allowed. Our beige mouse will give a demonstration. In this run, the mouse does not just stop and start, it actually turns around. This causes it to cover parts of the curve twice or even three times. This run will not be considered as a parametrization. This time, the mouse does not turn backwards, but it loops the circle twice. Once again, this run is not a parametrization of our circle. In fact, a valid parametrization should have the following properties. It should cover the entire curve, but it should also cover each part of the curve not more than once, with the possible exception of single points, like the start and end point, in the case of the circle. Okay, let's try to apply the whole setup to another curve, a line segment. More concretely, suppose that a line segment has endpoints A and B in the plane with coordinates 2,4 and 5,-1 respectively. As before, we can think of one of our mice running along the line. Suppose that it starts at A at t equal to 0 and then runs at constant speed and ends at B at t equal to 1. What are the coordinate functions that describe its trail? Well, note that at t equal to 1/3, the mouse is exactly at 1/3 of the line segment, So its displacement from A is exactly 1/3 of the vector AB. At t equal to 1/2, it is halfway through the line, so the displacement is 1/2 of the vector AB, etc. In fact, if at some point t the mouse is at position P, then the vector AP is exactly t times the vector AB, that is, t times the vector 3 minus 5. Note that we can take the t into the vector. We now know vector AP and the coordinates of A, so we can find that P has coordinates 2 plus 3t, comma 4 minus 5t. This gives precisely the coordinate functions x of t equals 2 plus 3t and y of t equals 4 minus 5t. The parameter interval is 0, 1. Together, the coordinate functions and the parameter interval give a parametrization of the line segment. It is important not to forget about the parameter interval. If we would allow t to get any value, then you get the entire line through AB, and that is not what we wanted. This is a fairly standard way to parameterize a line segment, but again, there are many more possibilities. In the exercises, you will be asked to indicate other parameterizations of this line segment. In general, it can be difficult to find a parameterization of a given curve. In the rest of this section, you will see examples of parameterizations of curves that commonly occur and applications of such parameterizations. Good luck!